My name's Matt, welcome back to the Xenomorph universe, and today I want to talk about the actual derelict, or the bone ship, or the space jockey's vessel, or whatever you want to call it, however it's been called over the years. Now, when I do these videos, I am talking primarily about concepts and stuff, what we see on screen for the first three films, because the rest of it to me is absolutely fucking rubbish. So if you're a massive Covenant and Prometheus fan, then this video is not for you. But if you're still here and you're still listening, there's one concept, if you watch the first three films, so Alien, Aliens and Alien 3, there's one concept that I thought that could have been changed in regards to Prometheus and what have you, just looking at the source material of the first three films, is the fact of this bone ship, this derelict, that it actually isn't a ship whatsoever. So when you actually watch the film, the shape of it and all the rest of it, you know, obviously it doesn't look like much like a ship, but that's the whole point, because it's an alien vessel, or it's an alien something. They say that it's been there for a long time. The three vagina-looking holes in the side don't really seem much like airlocks. They don't have to break in or anything like that. Yes, it could be left open, but it does seem like there's a ramp up, or it does seem like it's a more of a door than an airlock or something like that. The next clue that I kind of have from the whole first film is the fact that when they actually go into it and Kane goes through that melted surface, if you look at the height of Dallas, Kane and Lambert to the actual derelict when they're crawling, you know, when they're basically going in there, they don't seem to go up at any point, although, you know, we don't really see the full entry or anything like that. But it appears that the egg silo, as it's, you know, as it's been called, is actually underneath the ship, the supposed bone ship. We'll just call it the derelict from this point onwards. But it seems like it's underneath, but it also seems like the walls are made out of the same kind of stuff that the interior of the derelict is. So one idea that I did kind of have was that the derelict is actually a building. The main building is what we can see, and this would kind of make a bit more sense because of its architecture and stuff like that. Basically the shape of it, there doesn't seem to be any landing legs or anything like that. Now you could say it's crash landed, and you know, if you're shouting at the screen, Prometheus, Prometheus, fuck that, it's a lot of rubbish is that film, so look and all that. I'm talking pre this, after they ruined it. But when you actually look at it, you know, the silo could be just basically, you know, underground levels. And the other thing is that I would have played with as well is that they called the, you know, the space jockey or the pilot. To me, you know, forgetting that there's they've made its own engineers in there, that it also was a stupid idea. And someone has done a video on YouTube actually saying that you can actually see from the actual pilot, the space jockey, that his legs were basically missing. He wouldn't be able to fit in there if he was an engineer. But anyway, that's going off on a tangent and somebody else's video, which is actually quite a good video. But my point is this, is that maybe they were storing the eggs, something like that. There is that blue stasis field, if you want to guess, you know what I mean? But you could also argue the fact that it doesn't look like a pilot's chair. It actually looks quite like an MRI scanner or something like, or a telescope. It could be bloody anything. And that was the beauty of the film, was the fact that we didn't get the answers. We don't know what the fuck it is. And we never did find out. But you could say that it's a building, you know. Again, it's not, you know, Mother says after translating a bit of it, Ripley says in the film that it doesn't sound like an SOS. Well, if it was a ship, or if it wasn't a ship, then why would it be an SOS? It could just be a transmission, you know, warning others of their race, this site is contaminated, you know, it jumped on my face or whatever, I've become infected, I was trying to get the fucker out with that big machine thing and it was too late and it burst out. You know, the alien that run away, you know, I used to believe that the alien that burst out of the space jockey was then the one that melted its way through the floor and then became a queen or something and laid all those eggs. However, it just seems a bit convenient that they're not anywhere else but just in them stasis fields. So maybe, you know, to speculate that the alien did get out and it's somewhere else in the derelict, whatever. But I thought it was an interesting concept to think that something is a ship. Now, Ripley, you might say, you might start screaming at the screen, but Ripley has no reason to, you know, to have that information. She, like everybody else, just made a guess. She goes, there was thousands of eggs in that ship, you know what I mean? We went down on its beacon. She calls it a ship, and then we merrily run along with that story, thinking it's a ship. But there is nothing to say in the source material in the first three films that it was a ship whatsoever. She said it was a ship. She thought it was a ship. But I think it's quite good, and it's interesting to just think the fact that this is alien. How the hell would you know unless it takes off and starts flying about? You know what I mean? And even then, the definition of a ship and a building could be two different things. I think it would have been a much more interesting concept if you started watching Prometheus, they go through the story and all the rest of it, just on this space jockey idea, and they find out that it isn't a ship. You know, we were all expecting it was to be a ship. We've seen the trailers when it's rolling around, so it's obviously in the sky. It would have been a cleverer idea to have it not actually a ship, but a facility. You know, they do get there and say it's a facility. But anyway, forgetting all that rubbish, because that film is just fucking trash. Let me know what you think. If people have other ideas, stuff like that. You know, like I say, I am basing all this off the source material before Ridley Scott went on a rampage and ruined the entire franchise, as it's known. Hope that makes sense, and I will see you next time.